Hola a todos y bienvenidos a esta clase de inglés que cientos de ustedes me han pedido y tiene que ver con inglés para una entrevista de trabajo, para una entrevista laboral. En esta clase vas a aprender las 10 preguntas más comunes que te van a realizar y cuál es el vocabulario específico con su pronunciación que debes utilizar, al igual que las estructuras que te van a ayudar a que puedas conseguir ese trabajo. Vamos a iniciar con esta primera etapa que se llama Small Talk. Esta es una pequeña conversación que vas a tener en el momento en que conozcas a la persona que te va a entrevistar o las personas que te van a entrevistar. Las preguntas y respuestas con las que tienes que estar familiarizado, ya las tienes que tener en automático, son las siguientes para que no te pongas nervioso. Hello, sir, I am... Esto es lo que tú puedes decir o te lo pueden decir. How are you doing? How are you doing? Nice to meet you. Hello, sir. I am... Dices tu nombre. How are you doing? Nice to meet you. Una de las preguntas o preguntas que hacen muy típicas en este momento es la siguiente. What's the weather like? ¿Cómo está el tiempo? ¿Qué te parece el tiempo? How was your weekend? ¿Cómo estuvo tu fin de semana? Lleva así como que una pregunta ya y una respuesta, perdón, ya en automático para que tú puedas tener fluidez en esa entrevista. Y sobre todo que no te pongas nervioso, tienes que estar lo más calmado posible, ¿correcto? Bien, es por eso que en esta clase te voy a ayudar para que tengas una noción de qué es lo que te van a preguntar y qué es lo que vas a responder. ¿Ok? Algo también es lo siguiente. I'm great. Thank you. And you? It's my pleasure. Nice to meet you too. Hello, sir. I am... How are you doing? Nice to meet you. What's the weather like? How was your weekend? I'm great. Thank you. And you? It's my pleasure. Nice to meet you too. La primera pregunta muy común de estas 10 que vamos a ver en esta clase es esta. Puede ser cualquiera de las dos. How did you hear about us? How did you hear about us? Could you tell me how you heard about this position? Could you tell me how you heard about this position? Could you tell me how you heard about this position? A continuación te muestro alguna de las respuestas que ya debes de tener para que puedas tener fluidez en tu entrevista. I saw your ad in the newspapers. A friend of mine told me about this job. I heard about the position from my friend. I saw this position on internet. I read about the position on your website. One more time, repeat after me. I saw your ad in the newspapers. A friend of mine told me about this job. I heard about the position from my friend. I saw this position on the internet. I read about the position on your website. All right, the next question is this. What attracted you to our company? Or what do you know about our company? What do you know about our company? What do you know about our company? Why do you want to work here? Why do you want to work here? Why do you want to work here? Para dar respuesta a esta pregunta o a estas preguntas, te recomiendo mucho que hagas do some research, que hagas una investigación acerca de la empresa y acerca del trabajo que estás solicitando. ¿Cuáles son las habilidades que se requieren? ¿Okay? Diles a quienes te entrevistan cuáles son tus metas profesionales y de qué manera encajan con las de la empresa para la cual quieres trabajar. Puedes tener una respuesta de este tipo, podríamos decir. After doing some research about the company and the job, I think I have the skills and qualities for this job. I really believe in the value of customer care. After doing some research about the company and the job, I think I have the skills and qualities for this job. I really believe in the value of customer care. All right, next question. What are your strengths? What are your strengths? What are your strengths? What would you say is your greatest strength? What would you say is your greatest strength? What would you say is your greatest strength? Or what are your strengths? Okay? Te pueden preguntar cualquiera de estas dos. Very good. Las respuestas que la mayoría de los empleadores o quienes hacen este tipo de entrevistas son estas. Te recomiendo estos conceptos, este vocabulario. Te va a ayudar de mucho, ¿correcto? Repeat after me. My greatest strengths are teamwork, flexibility, discipline, and ability to learn from my mistakes. I'm a great team player. I find that this is very important when I'm working with people with different opinions. I can work under pressure and I have creative thinking. One more time. My greatest strengths are teamwork, flexibility, discipline, and ability to learn from my mistakes. I am a great team player. I find that this is very important when I am working with people with different opinions. I can work under pressure and I have creative thinking. All right, very good. Next question. What are your weaknesses? Okay, or could be the others, okay? What are your weaknesses? What are your weaknesses? What would you say is your greatest weakness? What would you say is your greatest weakness? What do you consider to be your greatest weakness? What do you consider to be your greatest weakness? ¿Cuál consideras que es tu más grande debilidad? Puedes responder, I think it's chocolate. Just kidding. Puedes responder esto, creo que es el chocolate mi más grande debilidad, ok, pero en realidad esto es para suavizar, para hacer más amena tal vez la entrevista, por si estás nervioso, dependiendo cómo sientas el ambiente, cómo sientas que va fluyendo la entrevista, ¿correcto? Esto lo puedes decir o simplemente no decir. En realidad a lo que ellos se refieren es otra cosa distinta a esto que pudiera ser la comida o algo relacionado con esto, ¿correcto? Entonces, puedes decir lo siguiente. Te lo recomiendo, tú puedes hacer tus adaptaciones. I sometimes expect people carry out their work to a high standard. And when that doesn't happen, I get irritated. However, I focus on my own job first and then I try to help them achieve a higher standard. I sometimes expect people carry out their work to a high standard, and when that doesn't happen, I get irritated. However, I focus on my own job first, and then I try to help them achieve a higher standard. También pudieras decir que tu más grande debilidad tal vez pueda ser public speaking, hablar en público, fear of failure, miedo al fracaso. Todo depende del tipo de trabajo. Y si esto no te pudiera traer algo negativo, una reacción negativa, ten mucho cuidado con esto, es simplemente lo que yo te pudiera sugerir, pero tienes que ser cuidadoso con esto. One more time. I sometimes expect people carry out their work to a high standard, and when that doesn't happen, I get irritated. However, I focus on my own job first, and then I try to help them achieve a higher standard. All right, next. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? 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 5 years from now, I would like to work in a management position. Until then, I would like to gain practical experience and learned a lot of things about the company. I am interested in growth. 5 years from now, I would like to work in a management position. Until then, I would like to gain practical experience and learn a lot of things about the company. I am interested in growth. Next. So, tell me something about yourself or run me through your CV. Cuando te hagan esta pregunta, no necesariamente te están solicitando que digas cosas privadas de tu persona. Más bien se refieren a cosas profesionales. Yo te recomiendo estas estructuras, este vocabulario, pero eso lo diría yo como maestro. En el caso tuyo tienes que ver cuál es tu experiencia de acuerdo a tu carrera, de acuerdo también al trabajo que estés solicitando, ¿correcto? Repeat after me. I have always been interested in education, so that's why I started teaching at university, specifically teaching English as a foreign language. I have worked as a teacher in 5 different schools for 10 years, mainly with students aged 14 through 19 years old. I am a committed, hardworking, and adaptable person who understands how important work is in life. I consider learning is a lifelong process, so I am always trying to improve my skills and qualifications. I also have very good organizational skills and always plan my week's work to perform to a higher standard. I have always been interested in education, so that's why I studied teaching at university, specifically teaching English as a foreign language. I have worked as a teacher in 5 different schools for 10 years, mainly with students aged 14 through 19 years old. I am a committed, hardworking, and adaptable person who understands how important work is in life. I consider learning is a lifelong process, so I am always trying to improve my skills and qualifications. I also have very good organizational skills and always plan my week's work to perform to a higher standard. Next, do you work well under pressure? This is a very, very important question. Do you work well under pressure? Do you work well under pressure? Do you work well under pressure? Working under pressure or without pressure is just the same for me. But to be honest, working under pressure is even better for me because I focus more on little details to achieve my goals. Working under pressure or without pressure is just the same for me. But to be honest, working under pressure is even better for me because I focus more on little details to achieve my goals. Next, when can you start? When can you start? When can you start? When can you start? Las respuestas para esta pregunta pueden ser las siguientes. I am ready to start immediately. I am ready to start immediately. I am ready to start right away. I am ready to start right away. I can be available to start as soon as the beginning of the next work week. I can be available to start as soon as the beginning of the next work week. Following question. How do you deal with stressful situations? How do you deal with stressful situations? How do you deal with stressful situations? I try to focus on the end result. I take a deep breath and I remind myself of my goals to stay positive. I try to focus on the end result. I take a deep breath and I remind myself of my goals to stay positive. I try to focus on the end result. I take a deep breath and I remind myself of my goals to stay positive. Tell me about a time you made a mistake. Tell me about a time you made a mistake. Tell me about a time you made a mistake. Ten mucho cuidado en esta última pregunta porque es muy importante para las personas que te están entrevistando. Principalmente buscan ver tu honestidad y cuáles son las acciones que tomaste para enmendar ese error que cometiste. Recuerda que todos somos imperfectos y en algún momento nos equivocamos, ¿correcto? A continuación te muestro un modelo, te muestro alguna respuesta que tú puedes adaptar y que tiene estos elementos que te estoy mencionando. Early in my career, I missed a deadline that cost some money from my company. There were many factors that contributed to this, but at the end of the day, it was my fault. I learned a lot from that experience. I thought really hard about what I could have controlled and what I would have changed. I took actions to ensure it didn't happen again. In fact, months later, I was able to get back that money for my company. Early in my career, I missed a deadline that cost some money from my company. There were many factors that contributed to this, but at the end of the day, it was my fault. I learned a lot from that experience. I thought really hard about what I could have controlled and what I would have changed. I took actions to ensure it didn't happen again. In fact, months later, I was able to get back that money for my company. Amigos, estas respuestas, estos formatos, estas estructuras las puedes adaptar a tus necesidades de acuerdo al trabajo que tú estás solicitando. Estas te van a permitir sonar más formal, que es una parte muy importante en una entrevista de trabajo. De mi parte, esto ha sido todo. Espero que haya sido de ayuda esta clase que cientos de ustedes me han estado pidiendo y no había podido hacerla, pero en este momento la tienes aquí contigo. Voy a dejar el PDF en la descripción de esta clase y ya sabes, no te olvides dejarme un like, un comentario, suscribirte a mi canal y comparte estas clases. Por favor, de esa manera me ayudas mucho. Nos vemos en la siguiente clase. Que tengas un excelente día.